So first up, we have Jay Dawkins, baby pics, citizen engagement, and cat pics. Who doesn't love baby pics and cat pics? Welcome, Jay.
Yeah, it seems like those babies are great until they get us sick, right? Well, tonight I'm going to start my presentation in a way I don't normally start presentations, but I think it'll work for this crowd. I'm going to start with some quotes. So that's for a company, Citizen. We started in 2014. We do civic tech for a few cities like Raleigh, Charlotte, and Miami, helping them with citizen engagement. But the first quote of the night, if I can get it, I'll get it in that way. You know this guy, Thomas Jefferson. His whole idea there is that human happiness and like our health are actually some key considerations of government. So it's a very high ideal for what we're working on, food inspections, you name it, serving that purpose. The second one, is anyone here like a fan of 18th century philosophy? Yeah. Lots of all right. David Hume, pointing out that government is founded on people's opinion. Meaning that there's nothing more to the power of the people in power than the opinion supporting government. So this last quote, it's from someone else that maybe you haven't heard of, but it's, can you believe they're tearing down Finch's Diner for that new interchange? And that is neither Hume nor Jefferson, that is my neighbor, Garrett. But the point of those quotes being, a lot of times, when we think about and when we think about our motivations for why we do this stuff, we're up in the clouds. You know, we have our high ideals for what we want government to achieve, but ultimately, to be able to achieve any of those things, we have to have a deep, great understanding of the people that we're trying to serve. And governments have been trying to figure this out for a long time, you know, since the early days of democracy. Athens, the forum, that was the first form of trying to engage people and trying to understand them. And still to this day, we're using a lot of that format. So when we think about how that format impacts the way people engage, we like to think of it at cities, and we think of it at different barriers or tiers to engagement. So public meetings being the old tried and true, I've been around forever, but they also have real barriers like space and time, people's schedules. So while they're very effective, it's also a challenge to get a very big impact with public meetings. Of course, when the internet came along, it changed everything. The tubes and pipes. It totally transformed how government got information out there. Obviously, up until that point, meetings and maybe the newspaper were our format. But the challenge still remained of how to get people to come to it. Even if you made it interactive and super easy to use, people don't know about it a lot of times, so the people that are super motivated are the same ones that are showing up at public meetings and driving the process. So of course social media, we've all interacted with, and we're using it tonight, it's a powerful tool. It's really enabled us to engage more in conversations around government and to let people share the things that are important. But ultimately, the people that are following those accounts, again, it's a very small handful of our society, and ultimately the social media algorithms make it very difficult for our projects to get up into mainstream thought. So there's this new layer of technology that's come out in the last few years that we focus on at Citizen, and it's targeted outreach. So it's using the tools that have come about in a new way, using actual advertising components of social media to reach specific groups of people, meaning by geography, demographics, you name it. People that we need to reach, instead of asking them to come to us, we go to them. So a quick illustration of how that works is here in the city of Raleigh, the bike plan, Raleigh bike plan. Some of you may have participated in that process. This was in 2015. They realized that a lot of people were the same folks coming up at the same public meetings, and they were missing a major chunk of the community, specifically Spanish speakers, and folks that may not have a license but rely on the bike to get around. So they reached out through Facebook to over 20,000 people in the city, 5,000 of those being non-English as a first language people through Facebook. And put these posts asking where are the streets that need improvement. And they got the same ones as the meetings were bringing about, but the people that spoke Spanish and saw the Spanish language posts actually engaged at higher rates than anybody else they reached out to. And all of a sudden, the speed of comments, you've got different roads and places that we hadn't thought of yet. But the really amazing part was that we leveraged the Facebook API to turn that into a public conversation in one centralized place. We brought the comments over into the main thread on the city's website, in their interactive survey. And then when someone liked something on Facebook, it turned into a vote on that same idea on the city's website. So ultimately you have this whole collaboration going on. And we're looking to innovate on that even further through partnerships with online news. This is something we do now with WRAL and The Observer and a few other smaller publishers. But putting city and local government polls into the topics that news is covering. And so through that, we reach about 250,000 people a week. We've had over 1.2 million votes registered through the platform on news. So it's a really powerful way for us to get those civic things out there. But so in closing tonight, number one, that last poll, sorry, was on transit. I want to second your comment about transit. Movingwakeforward.com, definitely check it out. November is a big month for transit in Wake County, if you head to the polls. So closing out, when you're online and you see, as you're scanning through the pictures of babies and cats, you name it, and you see a picture all of a sudden of Blue Ridge Road, take a moment and comment on it. Upvote ideas that you like on there. And in doing so, you'll be right there in the forum, contributing to the future of your city. And then, of course, when you're done, Mittens will be waiting for you on the next post. So have fun with that. Thank you guys so much.